The person who has skill in map making is called the cartographer. So maps are made according to the scale and according to purpose. According to scale, it has three major categories: the small scale map, the medium scale map, and the large scale map. So according to purpose, it has again many categories which are made according to the different purposes. So first of all, we will discuss the political maps. So these maps are made according to the purpose. We have the political boundaries of the maps are very important here. So every map has its own, every country has its own political autonomy. So that's why these maps are made. So here we have our best example of the South Asian region. So in South Asia, we have eight major countries like Afghanistan, Pakistan. The western side of South Asia is covered with the Afghanistan country. Here is Afghanistan. Then to the south of the South Asia is Maldives and the Sri Lankan islands. So the central part of South Asia is covered with India, and the northern part of South Asia has the Nepal and Bhutan countries, which are actually to the north of South Asia, and the eastern side of South Asia is covered with Bangladesh. So these are the eight major countries of the South Asia. Each country has its own political boundary, so that's why the political maps are very important. The second category of the map, according to purpose, is the social maps. Social maps, organizations, tribes, and races, and their languages, religion are depicted on these types of maps. So these maps are made by the process of certain techniques, but here we have certain purposes behind the social maps. Sometimes these maps are made because of the depicting certain religion, like Muslims are related to the particular areas. Here the map shows the different cultures of the world. So the northern part of Africa is covered with the North African culture. Central and south of Africa is covered with sub-Sahara African culture. The western side of Europe is covered with Northwest European culture. And again, the central part of North America is covered with the North American culture, Northeast American culture. So it means we have the different tribes of the world, or these are the small races of the world. So these maps are important. Why? Because to show the social groups of the world. The next category of map is called the communication maps. These maps are important to show the communication networks of the country, or even the region or the world. Like in Pakistan, we have major roads or highways, which are important for the means of communication, transportation of the countries. So here we can show the major roads of the country over the map. So these are important for travelers, for tourists. So these are maps which are important for tourist purposes. Now, some of the maps are made because of the economic purposes. So these are called the economic maps. So the distribution of important agricultural, mineral, and industrial products with important centers. So here we have again the example of Pakistan. The map shows the agricultural land use areas of the country. Now most of the area is covered with the yellow color. This color is actually under desert type of vegetation and shrubs, whereas the second most important area, which is under brown color, is showing the most of the agriculture land of the country. This land is called the Indus Plain. Now, the upper part of the Indus Plain is the Punjab province, and the lower part of the Indus Plain is called the Sindh province. Both provinces are important for the agriculture production of the country. So during summer season, we have rice cultivation, the sugar cane, and cotton are the major crops of the countries, and most of the crops are coming from these two provinces. And during the winter season, the major crop is wheat, and most of the wheat production is coming from the province of Punjab, or the Upper Indus Plain. Now, the Upper Indus Plain is irrigated by the five major rivers of the country: the Indus, the Jhelum, the Chenab, and Ravi and Satluj. So these are the major five rivers of the country and mostly belongs to the province of the Punjab. The green color shows the forest areas of the country, and it is mostly to the south of the country. Some of the northern side of the countries are covered with forest. So these are the areas where we have the natural vegetation, or we call it the forests. The south of Pakistan is covered with another activity, economic activity, which is actually under the fishing processing or fish processing areas. Mostly the harbors or natural seaports are there. So that's why the economic importance of the map of the country is very important. Next category of the map is called the distribution map. So here we have certain productions, but are related to the population or any natural aspect of the country, like temperature, rainfall, precipitation. So when we are dealing with the population clusters, so it means we are actually dealing with the clusters of the major population distribution, the thinly populated areas of the country. And when we are dealing with the temperature of the country, it means we not only deals with the daily temperature distribution, but monthly and annual based. The next category of the map is the choropleth map. Different shades by horizontal, vertical, and slanting lines may be adopted to show different densities of the population and other data. So here we have the major crops of the world. And most of the crops are belongs to the South Asian countries, the East Asian countries, the European lowland, the northern part of USA, and the central part of USA. So these are the areas of major crops of the world. So different color shows the different types of crops here. The next category of the map, according to purpose, is the historical maps. So past events are symbolized, or we can show on the map. Here we have the best example of the Indus Valley civilization. So the green color shows the spread of the civilization.